Well, today I want to think about the top 10 names by market capitalization in terms of public companies. So I want to think about how that changes over time. It changes considerably over time in a slow way. I also want to think about the fact that the big names have really dominated the market performance recently, but that is not always the case. So this is the current lineup of top 10 companies globally. We clearly see tech companies there, kind of online retail companies or and whatnot. We do see a Visa in there. Berkshire Hathaway was kind of a conglomerate, Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company. Those are all the current mix. If we go back a little bit, we're going to see that TSMC jump out, Johnson & Johnson pops in. If we go back another year to 2018, we are going to see that this Visa is no longer there. In fact, we're never going to see that again as we go back in time. JP Morgan, we see that for its one and only time in this group. And we see ExxonMobil pop in here, which we're going to see pretty much forever, kind of going back in time here. So you can see we're changing a little bit from tech to energy. And that's going to be a common theme as we go through this. And there's going to be obviously some banks in there. Hopefully, you'll see that as we go forward. Going back in time, the mix just changes. Nothing really that interesting there. If we go back again, Alibaba and Tencent are out, and we're never going to see them again. We see AT&T jump in there, and GE. If we go back again, we're going to see that Netflix and Facebook are out, and we're never going to see them again. Wells Fargo jumps in for a short period here, and we see some non-tech Chinese companies jump into the mix with PetroChina and this bank. If we go back here, we're gonna see Wells Fargo for its second and only time in this list in 2014, and we're gonna see Roche for its only time. Alphabet changed to Google, but it's essentially the same company here. Otherwise, the mix looks pretty similar. Going back here, again, we're going to see for the first time Walmart showing up in this list. We're going to see Chevron show up for its first and only time. Otherwise, again, the mix is pretty similar. But you can see we got two oil and gas companies here. We got a bank in here, and we have kind of these two kind of consumer type companies with GE and Johnson & Johnson in terms of maybe a little bit more of a conglomerate by nature. Going back in time, we don't see too much here. We see a mobile company come in here, IBM, another tech company show up here. Yeah. We keep going back again. Another oil company comes in. We see Beach Bob Bilton show up for its one and only time here, Nestle for its one and only time. But otherwise, again, kind of tech, energy. Go back to 2010, pretty similar. Procter and Gamble shows up for its one and only time in this mix. Go back again. All familiar names that we've seen in here before. So things are just kind of moving around. Go back to 2008. Again, same kind of names we've seen before. If you go back to 2007, well, for the first time, we see an auto company here. It's Toyota. It's not Tesla. Tesla has never been in this list. We see, AT&T, and we see a bank in here, some other energy companies. So banks, energy, one auto company. And kind of GE in terms of this kind of conglomerate type company, but always kind of a similar mix here, kind of a similar theme. Go back to 06, see a different bank show up here for a brief time. Citibank's in there for a little bit, but anyway, banks, financial institutions, sorry, banks and financial institutions, energy, and then of course, Walmart's still in there. Back to 05, for the first time we see a pharmaceutical company in there, but the mix, we've kind of seen a lot of these names before. If we go back again to 04, we see AIG for its first time. Again, bank, Pfizer still in there. Intel, we haven't seen that. Remember when that was going to rule the world? HSBC's back in there, similar companies. 03, we go back, just kind of everything's mixed itself up a little bit here. Go back to 02, kind of again, a reshuffle of things in here, similar types of companies. Go back again, we see Cisco. Remember when Cisco was like, that was again another company that was going to rule the world, best CEO, et cetera. That's in here for the first time. Vodafone's in here. So we're seeing, another mobile telecom type company. Go back to 2000, some new names in here. So NTT, Docomo, and NTT. Deutsche Bank. So here now we got, you know, kind of these the old school like Microsoft type companies, but we got a lot now. We're pretty much very telecom heavy. If you recall those days, go back again, similar names. Merck is in there, and Pfizer. So we have two kind of pharmaceutical companies in there. And for the first time, we see Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola has been around forever, but hasn't been in the top 10 for a good 20 years now, which is kind of crazy to think about it. IBM pops back in there, still a pretty prominent company. Go back again, Toyota's in there again. So for the second time in its history, it is in there. And we see Novartis and Coca-Cola still there. Now, the interesting thing is there, if you go through that list, the only company that was in the top 10 for all those years was Microsoft, and about close second was ExxonMobil. We definitely went from this kind of telecom, energy, tech in terms of Microsoft to a new world economy where we got Amazon and Apple and Alibaba and Tencent, some of these companies that just weren't there before. This thing does change. It takes time, but themes change. Now, tomorrow I'm going to talk a little bit about kind of what this means for investors. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that. I hope it wasn't too long, but I think it's pretty interesting to go back in time and look at how the market has changed. Thanks so much.